the problem. Success against terrorism. At great human and material cost, Pakistan has succeeded in turning the tide of terrorism and extremism. Our National Action Plan is the consensual blueprint of eradicating terrorism from our midst completely and holistically. Operations Radul Fasad and Zarb Azm have been resounding successes. 2019 has been the safest year yet. It is also the year we have opened up to the world with our revamped visa on arrival and online visa initiatives. This has paved the way for Pakistan's journey from a country known for terrorism to one known for tourism. The Kartarpur Corridor. Despite ongoing dire situation in occupied Jammu and Kashmir and the current slide in Pakistan-India relations, Pakistan established the Kartarpur Corridor to allow our Sikh brethren from India and around the world access to one of their holiest sites on the occasion of the 550th birth anniversary of the founder of Sikh religion, Baba Guru Nanak. In record time, what is now amongst the largest Sikh Gurdwaras in the world, Kartarpur was opened up to foreign pilgrims. Pakistanis warmly opened their hearts to welcome their guests and accord them hospitality. The Kartarpur spirit animated our actions. Kartarpur is a living testament to Pakistan's vision for the region and for Pakistan-India relations, which is one of peaceful coexistence, interfaith harmony, tolerance and amity, bridge building in the Islamic world. Wherever possible and however we could, Pakistan in its modest capacity has contributed to lessening tensions and the threat of war and promoting dialogue and diplomacy in the Middle East. We have unequivocally declared that we would not partake in any regional conflict and that we would only be partners for peace. We have been in the forefront in declaring that conflict would be in no one's interest and in calling for restraint and recourse to dialogue and diplomacy. Regional powers have acknowledged and appreciated our efforts. Crisis management with India. A year ago, our eastern neighbors' belligerence pushed us to the brink of war. India violated our airspace on a false pretext with a sinister design. The challenge before our leadership was to prevent war that would be disastrous for the region, while ensuring that the Indian aggression did not go unpunished. We were able to achieve both objectives. We laid bare the fiction of India's military might, exercised our right to self-defense, and demonstrated our will and capacity to respond to any misadventure. It was Pakistan's maturity, responsibility and restraint, but also a firm resolve to respond to naked aggression that de-escalated the standoff and helped preserve the peace. We have since seen India take a number